has everything.
Big Boy Big Neighborhood.
All righty, man. We got our dude Kevin Gates up in here. First off, I got to say, man, welcome to the neighborhood. We see each other outside of the studio, but it's a pleasure to have you here, man.
No, it's a pleasure. Thank you for having me here. Like,
man,
no, you know,
I had to. This was a long time coming. This was a long time coming right here, brother.
You got to be somebody to be on this show.
Man. So, well, like hell, we here every day. Yeah. And I guess we are somebody then.
Thank you.
Hey, man, just right now, before we got into the interview, I told Kev, I said, hey, man, can you put your headphones on? And he was like, oh, man, I'm just kind of getting used. You rock inner ears now. You said you don't watch TV or nothing? You said your house is quiet?
No, it's quiet. It's super peaceful at my palace.
Why is that?
It's no nothing like it's no. I don't have any philosophical meaning to
anything like that.
Mm-hmm. I just like to be around peace. And if you've went through and experienced as much pain as I have, mm-hmm. I've been through a tremendous amount of pain, physically, mm-hmm. mentally, spiritually. I've been through hell.
And, but you know what's
in
crazy?
In order to appreciate and understand great peace. You have to have went through and experienced great pain.
You know what they, but what's crazy also, man, they say sometimes that silence speaks louder than anything, but you know how to calm that down then.
It's super loud.
Yeah.
But like I say, I don't need to be distracted from anything. I love my solitude. I love my tranquility. I love my peacefulness.
So what do you do at the house? Like, are you watching the NBA finals or? You turn
it's
into TV.
It's gonna sound crazy. I'm not in the sports.
I heard that.
Wow.
I'm not. I don't care who win or lose. I like the colors of the. I like the Golden State Warriors colors.
Yeah.
I like the Cleveland Cavalier colors. I love the Boston colors.
Go ahead now.
And I've been wearing the Clippers colors. They red, white, and blue, and that's like Puerto Rico colors. I love.
Hey man, let me tell you what's crazy about that.
So
Kevin,
that's why I love them.
I'm on the like. I can, like, I'm into boxing, though. Like, I got to watch boxing.
I used to be.
You know, but, I like, when it comes to basketball, football, anybody lose, I can sleep that night. You know what I'm saying? Like, I don't have to worry about another man winning for me to feel good.
Mm. Right.
As long as I'm cool, I'm like, I'm
I like
good.
UFC now, but it's starting to get too corporate. So I'm starting to not like UFC.
Do you ever make it out to any of those?
No, I've never been to one. I did like boxing.
Mm-hmm.
The last time I ever saw Mayweather fight was when he fought Arturo Gatti. That was right after I got out of prison, right before I went back to prison. I saw him fight Arturo Gatti. He closed both his eyes in the sixth round. He was like, Kevin, why you don't ever come watch? Mayweather be like, why you don't ever watch none of my fights? I say, because I love you too much. You know, if I see somebody put their hands on you, I might shoot them.
Yeah, I heard that.
That's real love.
I can't watch you fight nobody.
Let me tell you when boxing got bad for me. Was when I started meeting the boxers.
Right.
And then it became reality for me. Like, one of my cats is Fernando Vargas. That's my partner, man. And when I saw him lose to Trinidad, I took that personally. And it's the same thing where you do want to hop overseas, Trinidad.
I like Deontay.
In. Yeah, yeah, dude is dope, too.
That ain't what I love about him.
What's that?
He said he got off from work, and he slept in his car and went to the gym.
To the gym. The story.
Like, his story is the same as mine. Like, I could have signed with anybody I wanted to. Mm-hmm. I walked away from one of the biggest labels at the time. Mm-hmm. I walked away from Young Money. Everybody told me, you crazy. But you didn't see my vision.
Mm-hmm. Why?
You know, I don't listen to what go on around me. I take everything in. I want to smell it. I want to touch it. I want to feel it. And if my heart not telling me do it, then I'm not going to do it.
At a time when, and still Young Money now, anybody would do that.
Mm-hmm. I'm talking about at the time when they was,
yes,
you know, the conglomerate, when they was, you know, when they was the Rockefeller of the
and
game.
And people really that had you, though, they had to also be like, man, what are you doing?
Yeah. My manager was, man, you tripping, bro.
Like, this is what we've been waiting on.
Yeah.
But you say also, man, that you weren't always, you know, there's some cats when they're young, they're like, man, I want to be a rapper. I want to be in
music. I sat around Birdman. And he told me about, man, I got this out the dirt. I came from nothing. And the pride and the confidence he said it with. And I was like, that's what I want for myself. Yeah. I want to get mine out the mud.
Some people, you know, more so.
I want mine out the dirt. I don't want no handouts. I don't want no no celebrity to co-sign me
right.
and somebody to see me in the street and say, I remember when such and such put you on. No.
Do you feel like, well, it's got to be. I mean, hell, you made the right decision.
It was by the grace of the Most High God and my beautiful wife that I am here today doing what I'm doing. I was not this person. Mm-hmm. I was not this person.
Well, when you say you weren't this person, what person were you? You know, because there's...
You want me to tell them the truth?
Please do.
I abused drugs. Mm-hmm. I abused drugs because my heart bigger than my body. And when I love somebody, like when I love you, that's why I don't get close to people now. Because when I love you, I don't care about what consequences come. I am the sacrificial lamb if I love you. Mm-hmm. I'm getting up out of my bed at 3 a.m. in the morning for you. I'm going to die for you. I'm going to kill for you. Whatever it mean, I'm going to do this. And the love I showed people, I never got that love back in return. Mm. Never. Never, not one time. It's every organization I was with that I helped make great, they will use me until they didn't need me no more. And that's what happened with every situation that I was in. So when I told my wife about Breadwinners Association, she believed in it wholeheartedly. And she was like, let's get it. I'm from the South. I'm from Louisiana. So my speech isn't going to be like everyone else's. Mm-hmm. But I try to use vernacular. That means proper English. Mm-hmm. I try to use it as much as I can.
Shit, but you use words that's bigger than... Come on, stop.
When the slang terminology come in, you're going to have to accept it.
Go ahead now.
But when you get used up and you get used and used and used, you begin to question, like, is there really a God? You know, and to numb this pain, you know, you try some of the, I'm a strong person. So it takes strong drugs to make me numb. And I've never been to rehab. Ever at one time in my life, because I believe that rehab is for quitters.
Damn.
We're not trying to quit. It's go hard or go home with me. And that's with anything that I've ever involved myself in.
Where you at now, though? You know what I'm
Brother,
saying?
I don't use drugs anymore.
Right.
And I could say this, I got the one thing that I came in the game wanting my whole life.
And that is?
A family. Mm. I never had a family. I called somebody that ain't even old enough to be my daddy, because mm-hmm. that's how bad I wanted a family. And every young male that grow up, and I ain't going to say black, I'm going to say because I'm mixed, I'm black and Hispanic. Every young male that ever grew up in a poverty stricken situation, that's all you ever wanted, was your big brother or your daddy mm-hmm. or mother. You wanted that. And because you didn't have that, you start looking at that in a negative manner. It's wrong. Nah, you got to make it uncool because you never had it. And that's the way I did. Like, to this day, I'm 30 years old. I be riding and see somebody playing basketball with their dad outside. I look and be like, what? F him.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? But I got to remember. My son will never know what that feeling is like.
I heard that. And how old is your son now?
He's 2.
Man, how has fatherhood, has it changed you?
Fatherhood didn't change me. Mm-hmm. The transition was made once I made the decision. Because a lot of times when you're in the streets, you can have an institutionalized way of thinking. And that's a lot of people that have been in the streets. Like, you'd be like, he's so cold-hearted. It's not that we cold-hearted, but we know it's only a matter of time before we go back to jail. Mm-hmm. So I can't even love my children like I want to. I can't get close to my wife because when I go to jail, I don't want to be in there stressing about them. Mm-hmm. You the first person I'd have told this to. I can't believe I'm telling you.
That's now?
Like I say, I've overcame that.
Right.
I've overcame that. It took a lot of fighting with myself to overcome that, but that was me when I first had my daughter. It wasn't that I was afraid of the responsibility of the child. I was afraid of being a letdown to them. So I couldn't love her like I wanted to because I felt like I'd go back to jail anytime and I don't want to be in jail. It's a weakness in jail. You miss family.
Right.
You crying. What was wrong with you? I walked a tear where no tear should ever fall. I'm forever hard. Give me whatever charge. I walk whatever yard. That's the oath. That's the oath you take when you say you're in the streets. So it had me to the point where I couldn't even love my own family.
Did you think that you would be here? Not here.
I never saw this. When I first met the people at Atlantic in New York. The lady told me, I told the lady, I say, you know I wasn't supposed to be here. So I don't care what happened.
Right.
Because I died a day. I died a day tomorrow. I did something nobody from my neighborhood ever did. I did it. Nobody from my neighborhood ever did it. But I did it. By the grace of God and my beautiful wife.
Do you choose to be alone?
Yeah.
Why?
Because I love my family. I don't need no friends.
Yeah, man.
What I need a friend for? I am the bodyguard. I am the protection. I can't say that ain't nothing gonna happen. But Dreek, no. I'm gonna die for us, babe.
I heard that. And nobody on the payroll would do that for you.
I'm gonna die for us, babe.
There's a loose phrase of when people say, oh, keep it real, or he's real. You know what I'm saying? Like, I've always gotten from you that the Kevin Gates that I see in the mall, the Kevin Gates that walk in here, wherever I see a Kevin Gates or anybody that's out there, it's going to be this guy. It's not like a cape. You know what I'm saying? Are you turning to Kevin Gates?
Well, I do have on somewhat of a cape today.
Go ahead now.
Rudyard Kipling said, to thine own self be true. And that is the greatest reality. So if you skateboard or you ride BMX bikes or dirt bikes or whatever you into, that is the real you. If you're not afraid to be who you are, that is the real you.
What do you do for like without music? What do you do for fun? Like if you just want to have a good day?
Wrestle with my children.
I heard that.
Wrestle with they big fine ass mama.
Hello. Hello. Hey, man, was it hard to arrive?
Yeah, have arguments, you know. She like, Kevin, I just took a shower. What you mean you took a shower? I bathed you. You know, just had a little argument. Right. Like
hey, man, was it hard to arrive? Like, whatever life temptations are, you know what I'm saying? If it is, you know, streets, if it is the hustle, if it is the drugs, if it is other women, was it hard to arrive where you are right now?
No, my biggest problem was overcoming myself. And once I defeated myself, like, me and my wife used to argue all the time. They'd be like, yeah, Kevin, you made her. No, I didn't.
Right.
She made me.
Well, here now. She back there shaking her head, too. Like, she, yeah,
made,
I did.
She made me, though.
You got to turn around
like,
and check.
I don't
like,
mind
yeah,
telling
yeah.
people that. Like, I was, yeah, I hustled in the streets. And when it came to getting on that gangster, you know, getting on that tip, you know, I can do that all day. But when it came to being a man and responsibilities, I would always run from that. I always ran from responsibilities and being a man because I ain't want to step up to the plate. You hear me? Mm. You know, I'm going to be honest with you. Like, I went through what all males go through. Like, I don't know if I want to get married. I'm telling you, the best thing you could do in life
is
you go to sleep on side of somebody you don't know and wake up and see if you still got everything that you had before you close your eyes.
Right.
You know,
or
man.
Or got to keep waking up checking.
Hey, it's cold, but it's fair.
Yeah.
You don't ever see dudes that be call themselves so-called players, and you look stressed out.
What was it about her that made her so different than anyone else?
And it's been years, though.
She had standards. I've been with her like 14 years.
Wow.
And she had Nato. That wasn't what we argue about, though. I don't have problems. I go leave the house. I don't come back till 8, 9 in the morning sometime. I don't get them calls like, where you at? And I don't have them kind of calls. The kind of arguments we have is, you know you too big to even be associating with that type of person. Or you know, Kevin, you too big to even do. You know, no, this been since I was, you know, she used to come pick me up off my block. You know, at nighttime, I was like, babe, I need to be held. She come and get me off the block. I've been hustling 2 days, 3 days straight. I'm tired.
Do you feel like your queen know you better than anyone in the world?
Way better than me.
Yeah.
And then, you know, I used to tell her, babe, I'm tired. Then once I found... I used to hear people talk about it. I didn't know it. Once I found the elixir of life, I no longer get tired.
Man, can you tell us what that is, or do I have to find it?
One,
I'm tired as a motherfucker.
You break that
right
down and
signs are for the conscious mind, and I cast not my pearls to the swine. But the elixir of life, it does start with meditation.
Mm-hmm. Damn.
You ever went to sleep and woke up tired?
Right.
I mean, the mind was never quieted. The mind never received true rest. And I ain't trying to sound like no philosopher, no prophet or nothing, but I'm not happy, but I am at peace right now. I'm talking about pure peace. The things that I'm doing right now is amazing to me. Like, I done had another rapper talk slick, you know, and I just gave him a hug. And boy, you know, I could smash you then.
Mm-hmm.
Slang dang-a-lang to your mama, and you know this.
Mm-hmm.
But I'm really, may peace be upon you, brother. I don't even know where it come from. I be looking at myself in the car like, boy, you know you pussy. I be looking in the mirror like, you really spare, dude? Like, you know. Yeah, I just be like, he know not what he do.
Right. That's crazy. I had this same conversation with my wife last night, bro, on everything I love.
She seen it. She was like, Mr. Friendly. She was just, she was, that's a little joke for me because everybody I see now, I'd give them hugs.
Yeah, man.
She was like, Mr. Friendly. Dude spilled red wine all on me on the plane. I told him, he, man, Kevin, I'm so, don't even worry about it, brother. You was just excited.
Go ahead.
How did you find that inner peace? Like, how, like, you seem so calm. Like, I feel it. It's so crazy. Like, how are you able to meditate? It's like the hardest thing for me.
Do you know what meditation is?
I know what it is. Do you do a mantra?
How are you able to meditate?
Yeah, like
that's
how?
A trick question. You just sit there.
How
and
do
meditate.
You do that?
You just meditate.
But like, do you like blank out? Like, you, how? Because I've tried. I've tried to like how they say like just space out. Like just get everything out of your mind and find your center. And I've never been able to do that. Like I've tried mantras and I can't do that.
You have to turn off all that.
You noise. May have what they call it. You know what I'm. You know, I'm a psychologist.
Yeah, man.
Yeah, I do know that.
You may have you may have excessive brain activity. And I don't believe anyone has more excessive brain activity than me.
Go ahead.
Because I'm ADDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDDD
life, I'm like, man, I can't turn my brain off. Like, I just started meditation.
That's just one step is meditation. It has a lot to do with the way you eat. And I don't want to sound like a philosopher, bro. I don't.
Why not? Shit, we here. No.
It ain't that, bro. It's just, you know, like I say, the knowledge is power.
Hey, man, let me ask you this. You
and great knowledge in the hands of a fool would be self-destruction. And I'm not about to give all that away. But I promise, I invite you to ever come to my house one time. I live right close to where I saw you at.
Mm-hmm.
Not that close, but I live close to there. And brother, if you ever come, just one time, just come by yourself. I just want you to come. You take your shoes off before you enter the house. And I just want you to feel what you feel. And just tell me what you feel. I done had a bit of everybody want to come over there and tell me, it's just so peaceful over here, Gatesburg. Just how I get, like, your house could be like this, too.
Mm. What about the kids, though?
They bad.
Yeah, yeah. Do you have a noise area?
No, because they not that kind of bad. They like me. They don't do no talking. They going with their move. I don't make a lot of noise whenever I did something. I never told, oh, I'm about to do. I just did it. I did that. Yeah. Who feel played about it? Because I did that. And that's just me. I'm not about to, like, I ain't never been that person to scare you because I hate bullies.
Mm-hmm.
I feel like when I make the move, it's supposed to be like a praying mantis. Unexpected. You know what you did, though.
Yeah, hell yeah. And you know why.
Right. So I ain't got to get on Instagram. Mm-hmm. And, man, you, I don't get on Instagram.
Hey, man, does that trip
do
you out now?
I don't do all that.
All the modern day stuff that people do?
You know what the rawest, the coldest, you know what the best thing on earth is?
What's it?
Evidence.
Yeah.
I don't care what you think. You could, all that's evidence. You do all that. That's cool. But I don't care what you think about me. Prove it. Because I signed up for this.
I heard that.
I said I'm a gangster and a gentleman. Most people tell me, Gates, I'm a gangster. I'm a good father.
Because
I don't care about what your gangster and mine is two different definitions. You heard me? You, this new technology. Y'all on Instagram, you heard me?
So like when people were like questioning how good or bad of a father you were when you uploaded the video, I believe with your son in the car and without a car seat, like you just ignored that backlash or just all the comments and negative things that people had to
I say. Never heard it.
I love that.
I'm not on social media. I never heard it.
Wait, you not on social media?
No.
So who am I seeing all these pictures and videos
I put up a video and...
Oh, but you ain't going back.
Let it go.
For what?
Yeah,
because they're still up there.
Right. Me and my son was bonding. We was having a moment. I was teaching them how to drive.
Go. And how old is your son?
He two.
I love
you. You learn fast. Either you learn fast or you die young. Had I had the seatbelt on when my incident occurred, I would have not been here today. Mm. God is my seatbelt. And anyway, if it was meant for me and my son to die, we're going to die together. Having father and son moment.
I heard.
That's better than letting him run out in the street by himself with no... You're supposed to train up the child in the way that he should go. So I let him run out here with no principles, no morals, no nothing. A police stop him and tell him, hey, da-da-da-da-da. And you're not used to hearing authority.
Because
you used to being raised by your big sister or something. Because that ain't your mama. You know, it's probably your big sister or somebody. Mm. You know, because she's still immature in her mind. And every time somebody fuss at you, you getting in your feelings. And the police blow your brains out because you can't handle authority. Mm. But when you, he pussy, yes, sir, okay, thank you, okay, have a nice day, sir. Mm. You already a hoe, I can't win, which you got a badge. You like, Jesus Christ, you do whatever you want.
Right.
So I'm teaching you, I'm equipping you, I'm teaching you how to survive when I tell you, hey, tighten up, you too loose. Stand at attention because you know one thing.
You tell your two-year-old that?
Yeah, tighten up, you too loose. You running around the store, knocking stuff all on the ground, hey, tighten up.
I heard that.
I ain't about to tell you twice. And if somebody feel played.
Do you discipline by the hand?
I'm going to whoop your ass.
Go ahead.
And I'm a nigga, too.
Right. Go ahead now.
And a spit.
Go ahead. Wow.
I'm a nigga and a wetback.
Mm-hmm.
So when you call somebody that, you talking about me.
I heard that.
Yeah. So I'm called all of these things. My mother is Hispanic. My dad is black. So I'm a nigga and a spit, wetback, whatever you want to call it. I'm all of those things. So I'm going to discipline my child. So no police officer has to kill him because he never been disciplined before. So I'm going to discipline him. I'm going to make sure he conduct himself in the proper manner because, like I say, this ain't our land anyway. You playing and all that, you hear me? We come from a different realm. We just passing through here. You hear me?
Let me ask you this.
The greater teachers teach without speaking. So your conduct should display the things that I've imputed into you, the knowledge and the wisdom.
Why do you think you so-called made it as a rapper? You know how that's... And the reason why I'm asking this is because there's some people...
It's a curse.
It seems like
God
it's bigger.
I ask God to take this away from me all the time. I do not like being an artist.
Right. But let me tell you why I ask that. There's some things that people do, and that's what grabs the attention. Hmm. And then the real purpose is something else. You know what I'm saying? Like even with Magic Johnson... Magic Johnson was a hell of a basketball player, but Magic wasn't put on this earth just to score points and
right.
get you championships.
You was right, Rico. I love you. You was right.
Right.
What finish saying what you about to say.
And then there's a purpose that's after that. That's bigger.
Yeah, she argued me down. Kevin, you know you're not. This just, you sound just like Rico.
Right. So this is the, in speech class, when you take stuff like that, they tell you to bring attention to yourself first. Hey, I'm about to, then boom, you got everybody's attention. Yep. Then you hit them with the message. Mm-hmm. That seems like that's what's going down right now. Now, we can say, oh, man, Billboard and number two and the album of the year. But then that is for all eyes and ears to be set.
I'll say this. I always knew who I was. And I always ran from my true purpose. Mm-hmm. I'll say that.
Mm-hmm.
I always knew who I was. I always knew what I was. And if I did anything, I took full responsibility for what I did, no matter what it was good or bad. I took full responsibility for it. And I understand that this is what I signed up for.
Mm-hmm.
So I enlisted for this. And I know, like I say, since birth, I always knew what I was and who I was. And I know what my job is, and I always ran from it.
Mm-hmm.
I am now fulfilling my purpose now. I'll say that. I'm starting to fulfill my purpose.
I want to ask you this. Now, when we talk about just, like, I think if somebody asks you something, if I were to say, hey, man, a girl say, do I look fat in this? You probably say, hey, you know, in a certain way, like, yeah, you do look fat in that. You know what I'm saying? Like, there's just a truth that seemed like that come out of you. Now, did you go to Apple and sit down with the people from Beats?
Yeah.
And was there a comment that you made about Beats headphones?
Yeah.
What was that?
I told them that they headphones suck.
And man, you're there with them at this moment?
I told them the truth.
Yes.
I like Sennheiser better because, like, I'm not no boom, boom, boom bass man.
Mm-hmm.
I like quality over quantity.
Go ahead now.
That's just me. I love quality.
Then. Really, really.
I like bowls.
Go ahead.
They cool. I like Nakamichi a little bit. I ain't really heard them. I heard them in one vehicle, and I like them. But I like Sennheiser. I like bowls. I never had. And I love those Bob Marley headphones. Mm.
The wood ones?
The Bob Marley.
You know, the wood.
Yeah.
You know, the. I love those.
Those are dope.
So
Beats? I've seen them, but I've never
Beats? No.
So when you tell them, they did ask you.
You can't give me a pair of headphones and make me put them on and be like, hey, this, I'm not about to agree with that.
Mm-hmm.
Like when they asked me about the Kendrick Lamar, man, when he said he was the king of New York, I was like, that boy must have read All the Wall. I said it in a song.
Mm.
But when I heard the comebacks, I was like, nah, I'm not about to agree with that because, no, that's not raw. That wasn't, the comebacks wasn't raw.
Right.
I ain't heard nobody come back yet. Because, you know, I'm just not in that battling lane. So, if, like, I salute him because I like what he do. He's super witty. If he is ever to diss me, I'll be like, ha-ha. And I'll stay in my lane because that ain't my lane.
Mm-hmm.
But, like, the people that's in that lane, I can't agree with that. Like, me and my dude, I got a dude named Jim Guns. He from New York.
Mm-hmm.
We argue about music all day. He was like, man, bro. Kendrick Lamar, bro, he tough. Fred the Godson, he tough. Them some Loaded Lux, he tough.
Mm-hmm.
But like I say, they got a lot of people that's not tough. And be trying to jump in that lane, you got to be who you are. It's cheaper to be yourself.
Hell yeah, it is. Man, so do you feel like you have a lane?
Yeah.
Or you just know,
I'm cool.
I'm not putting my blinker on coming over to that lane.
No. I'm in my own lane and I hog it. Mm-hmm. I give the utmost respect, but I demand mine.
I heard that.
And you don't have to give it to me. And if you don't, I'm not going to be confrontational with you. I'm going to politely vacate the premises. Let the clown have the circus. You know, but you know, in a room full of clowns, man, I can't be part of the circus, man. When you entertain a clown, you become part of the circus.
It's very true.
Oh, man.
I'm serious, though. Like, what's going to be special about me if I argue with a clown? The world full of suckers, man. I mean, the world full of lollipops. I can't be just another sucker.
I heard that,
bro. You can do that. Man, I go play with my children.
What brought you to psychology?
I wanted to understand myself. Because for a period of my life, everybody was like, you the devil. I was in and out of prison for a long time.
Mm-hmm.
The first time I ever went to jail, a lot of people don't know this. I was 13. I don't know why I'm telling you this. You know who took me to... Nah, I ain't gonna leave.
No, brother, go.
No, send me to jail. I'm not even gonna put that on.
Apparent.
It don't even matter. But for a long time, people always said I was the devil, I was evil. And I know. I stand for what I believe in. I stand for what I believe in. My grandfather always instilled and imputed the knowledge and wisdom in me. He said, if you're a man, you stand up for what you believe in. And when you stand up for what you believe in, you accept the consequences that come behind it. Cool. I'm cool with the consequences. Because when I was in the streets, I wasn't in the streets for me. I was in the streets for the people that I love so they could be straight. So if I did go to jail from a poverty-stricken environment where there was no outlets, no nothing to do but go to jail or get killed, at least I tried.
Mm-hmm.
I can rest assured at night knowing that I gave it 100%. I'm cool. I signed up for this.
What made you, like I took psychology, right? And yeah. I think that's something I ran from, too.
Go ahead, I'm sorry.
The reason why is because I started analyzing
everything. Everybody.
Everything, everybody.
And
my thing was like, oh, man, you do, oh, you know.
But
oh,
it's a great area because it's like when you in the street, excuse me. Us,
right?
Not you, a street cat too, but us. We had already been analyzing people and putting them into categorizing behavior patterns and things of that nature. But instead of you being the interrogator or something like this, or after we do the individualistic approach, and you know, after you know, instead of you being the playing aloof and all of that, you might be one of my sales, one of my customers. You act like Mr. Joe. You know, I done seen your kind before. You act like my homie.
Right, right, you know, right,
so we categorized it differently. But it's a gray area because it was only what one person thought, and everybody's bipolar. Let them tell it.
Mm-hmm.
I studied it. It was cool.
And you got your psychology degree while incarcerated?
Yeah, but it was a trick to how I did that. Like, I took online courses.
Mm-hmm.
You hear me? And you're not supposed to. Anyway, but you get an administrator. Anyway, I hate to say this, bro. You know, because people be like, no, he lying. But I never been in administrative segregation or protective custody. I have to say that. No matter what your status is, you're a high-profile inmate, whatever. You sign a waiver, and you live in general population. And I never checked off a line or hit the button to move. That mean that wherever I stood on all 10. Mm. Whatever came to me, I accepted it. And I'm not the type to go to jail and join different gangs and all that. No, I stand on all 10. That's just me. I had to say that. What you get is an administrator to administer the test. And you could take as many tests as you want to all day. If you want to take four of them in one day, you know I'm not posted. You can do that. And you send them, you mail them to your professor, and your professor grade them for you and send them back. And it goes like that when you're in prison. You're not going on no college campus and shackles. So a lot of people are like, how did you do that? It really ain't none of your business how I did it, but you're the first person I told this to. I told somebody else, like, I alluded to it, but you can go, you get your administrator to administer the test, and you take them in front of them to make sure you're not cheating, you're not.
Right.
Make sure you're not cheating, and then they mail them out and send them back graded.
But that's so dope that you.
But they give you the book to read. You read the book. They're going to ask you the questions out the book that you read. So, like, I don't understand how complicated it is.
Right.
I ain't got nothing to do with back here. I don't watch TV back here. I barely get on the phone. I don't accept visits. Don't visit me. Because when you visit me, I'm like, for the first 15 minutes when I get to the visit, you know I'm going to wear the sock on my on my dangling, you know. Babe, suck your finger. Ooh, right. I love you, babe. Where you want me to skeet it at? You know I'm here. We pretending, you hear me? That's cool. Then when you leave, I'm going to want to leave with you. And psychologically, that could cause me to do something violent.
Mm-hmm.
I might go back to the maximum security unit and somebody tell me the wrong thing and I flash.
Right.
You know, I flash, you know. I have a fistic encounter with another inmate. You know, that's what they call that. You hear me? They had to put me in lockdown. I can't even do me like I want to. That don't look good on your jacket when you get to traveling.
Mm-hmm.
And ship you out to other prisons. That just don't look good. You know, I don't have none of that on my... Like, I don't have sexual misconducts on my jacket or nothing. That's called a 21. Like, how you get a sexual misconduct around nothing but men? And I had to realize they got some men that female guards, they expose themselves to. You know, silly things of that nature. But you're not even that special for me to even be liking you like this. You know, I just always was mind over matter with me. So I'm sorry that I went off into a lonely.
Nah, brother.
You know, but I wanted to paint the picture of how my day go. I get up at 4:30, I might work out. You know, after that, I might go to first child, I never go to second child. And it depends on what they having for third child. I might go to third child, but I get vegan trays.
Really, though?
Yeah.
How long have you been home? Has it been, your last turnaround was what?
2014. I've been home since 2014.
That's crazy.
I don't be remembering, big brother. It just... kind of
now when you move around together. Now when you travel just with certain things, is it harder for you to travel now?
The level of respect is so nothing out here. Like, it's just some, I see why some people miss being in prison, because in prison you're not gonna pass by a man and not say excuse me. I've been here 20 years, I kill you for that. I don't care where you come from, I don't care how many bodies you done caught, you ain't done caught none of here. You ain't got no knife yet. You pass around here being all khaki. You know. One down, boss.
How do you keep your little ones from a certain life? For one, you're going
to
be there.
I don't, because y'all get to see it. Like, if I take you in the hood and show you, like, you know, this way that lead. You know, like, my children going with me to prison. Lord say the same Sunday. We going to prison. me, my wife, my two children, we are going to prison to visit somebody. I just got cleared to where I can go visit an immediate family member. So when a child grew up going to these places and seeing this, you know what I'm saying, and seeing the outcome of this, man, this dude been down 20 years. You got to watch him grow up behind the bars. Mm-hmm. Who wants that life? Who wants that for themselves? I don't want to be in jail for the rest of my life. It's beautiful out here. But I'm glad that I went through jail because I can appreciate my freedom, because freedom is a privilege.
Election year. We were just talking about this all.
No, man, that made me mad. Like when dude said that, though.
Okay, and what was
said? He offended me when he said that. He was like, man, F Donald Trump. And I was like, no. Because you say you believe in God, right? Mm-hmm. You believe in a higher power. You're like, yeah. I stood up in the meeting and I was like, well, you would say F Donald Trump, but, you know, let's be honest. You know, when George Bush was in office, you heard me. The numbers was a lot lower on a lot of the, you heard me. You know, and wasn't the police brutality wasn't going on like this here? How it was. But then when you got your savior in there, you know, look what been going on. I say, now you will say F Donald Trump because he said something about Muslims. But what he don't know is a true Muslim is a Jew and a Christian. He don't know that. So it takes somebody showing him that type of love. They were like, so what you would do to him? I said, I'll walk up to him and give him a hug. I said, you know, he'll be mesmerized when I hug him and salam alaikum, brother, I love you. Like, he'll be mesmerized. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? He would. I was like, that's the approach. The approach should be love and not no F him. You know, did it. You know what I'm saying? Because I like when he get to talking that gangster shit. You heard him? He be funny to me. And a lot of stuff, he don't know what he be talking about, but right. He be funny. Like, I like him. You heard me?
Do you vote?
And
I'm a convicted felon. I can't vote. I'll never be able to vote.
Never.
I didn't know that.
Oh, yeah.
If you're a convicted felon, you didn't lose
that.
Right.
I'm too
That's
convicted.
Unfortunate that I didn't know that.
All right. Anyway. I'm blessed.
Right.
I'm glad I can't vote.
Really, though, what do you encourage others or?
For what?
Why not?
What's meant to be will be, brother.
Mm.
And you know what I'm saying. I ain't about to be. I'm not one of them people, bro. I'm not one of the people. Man, it's a conspiracy. I don't do all that. I just live my life in a peaceful manner. I just pray don't nobody complain with me.
Mm-hmm.
You hear me? I don't live my life worried about, you know, who doing this and who doing that. Like I heard somebody tell me, man, Kevin, you know, once you get in the music business, you're going to have to sell your soul. Have you ever been in the music business?
Right.
Like, have you ever been in the music business? Or no. Like, so no hard work going to it, because I wish I could just sign on a contract.
Right. Especially when things are crazy.
Especially go get somebody I don't like and act like I like them and get them smashed. That's all I got to do. And I'm good for life? Man, come on. Man, I died for this here, man. Going in clubs with my pregnant wife. She had to take the CD in there and DJ and tell the DJ what songs to play. I'm in there with a ice pick in my back pocket. And, you know, it's just me and her. She going to get the money. I got to watch her with the money. She can't go put the money in the car because the car outside by itself. I got to rap on stage and be looking at her the whole time. You know, like, who wants to live like that? But it's what I had to go through to get where I'm at. Like, I wish they had a magic button.
Mm-hmm.
If you don't work, you don't eat.
That's
if
real.
You don't grind, you don't shine. Mike Jones said that, I think, a long time ago.
Hey, man, aside from hip-hop, what do you listen to? Like, not rap-wise, not, you know what I'm saying, but if you just at the crib, what if there was something in your car, I say, man, you listen to that?
Oh, yeah. You're gonna laugh at me. Like, don't laugh at me.
If I'm the valet guy.
I like Nina Simone.
Go ahead now.
Nice.
Cinnamon. I like songs. Mm-hmm. I like Tracy Chapman.
Yes, sir.
And
had you the got a fast car.
That I belong. Yeah, I love that.
Do you think you have an old soul?
I like Ed Sheeran's first album.
Mm-hmm.
I don't think I got an old soul. I got the oldest soul.
Mm.
I've been awakened, brother. I've been here. And I know how long. You know, like I say, but I was mad that I allowed myself to be, and I'm going to just speak on it because it's the truth. I'm mad that I asked for the wisdom, but because it's a lot of stuff that you wish you just didn't know. With great wisdom comes great grief.
Mm-hmm.
And I could say, but like I say, like, I love my family. I've been having fun with them.
I heard that.
But it's a lot of things that I wish I didn't know. Like, I ain't know the double XL lady. Was, you know, I loved you. I'm your friend. I didn't know she was going to take a negative situation and build a story around it. Mm. Something that never happened.
What story was that?
Whatever story it was. But you did that, like, and I was like, how you do that to me? Because I know you. I'm the only artist that probably takes your phone. You know, and tell you, you know what I'm saying? But anyway, that's neither here nor there.
Do you still get surprised by people?
That surprised me. Wow. Because we had a relationship for a few years. And when you have that type of situation going, it'll make you want to implode. But I say, you know what? I'm going to stay positive. I'm going to stay positive because I'm not here for me. And human beings aren't perfect.
Man, let me tell you what's crazy about sitting down with you, man. We haven't talked about an album. You know,
who cares about an album? Like,
we ain't talked about a single.
It's gonna do what it's gonna do. Right. Like, I don't care about music. Like, that's what you understand. Like, I make more money.
That's what I understand.
Big brother, I make more money. I hate to say this. I make more money off coffee than I do off this shit here. This shit here don't do nothing for me.
Right.
If you look at the inside cover, what the inside cover say? The thank yous. All praise, honor, and glory be to the Most High. That's it. I ain't thank nobody but God.
Mm-hmm.
It's going to sell what it's going to sell. It's already.
Do you watch numbers?
For what?
Because you figured you came out and you did what, 100?
I don't know and I don't care. I don't want to talk about numbers because if I do, I'm going to say, which songs sold the most?
Mm-hmm.
And I'm going to make all of my music. I'm a demographic type of guy. I'm going to make all of my music based off of what that song did. And you're not allowing yourself to feel anymore. So you neglected yourself. You went against your own soul. You've wronged your own soul. Because as an artist, you say, I'm going to think and I'm going to feel my own thoughts. And you're going to say, I'm going to work with the people that I have good energy with. Like, if it take 1,000, like they ask me, how you feel about Ghost Riders? No kind of way. Because if it take 1,000, me and 1,000 other people to make one great song that's going to last for the rest of the earth, then we did that together,
right,
collectively. The great minds came together and we made the great souls. We made that great song.
Do you feel like sometimes, even with hip hop, like everything you're supposed to say, you're supposed to write? But with R&B or other genres.
Man, I don't know,
they
bro.
Can speak, they
man,
can sing the most beautiful lyrics that they don't have to write.
These dudes is different to me. I don't understand what world these dudes come from. Like, why not be appreciative? You blessed. You got money, you blessed. Do you have old lady or not? I don't know. Go get you a girlfriend and go have you a nice family and y'all go travel. It's beautiful over in other countries.
Mm-hmm.
I love to go eat in Brussels.
Go ahead now.
They have great food over there in Belgium.
Do they have Brussels sprouts?
I don't know. But I didn't know that the Belgium waffle came from over there. They got good food. Like, when you get to traveling, man, I'm thinking about these dudes in the game. I don't care what they do. Man, my little boy cursed me out last night. That was funny to me. he really looked at me and curse me out. I say, man, say, bro, you know, but I'm going to ask you, like, I want to know, like, what you mean?
Mm-hmm.
And if you used it in the correct manner, I salute you.
Go ahead now.
You can use those words. Because I look at them like exclamation points. Like, I say, big boy, watch out for the Rockwaller. I say, big boy, watch out for that mother Rockwaller. And I guess it comes from, I guess me being Hispanic, like, you could say te amo. Te quiero mucho, mi amor. Te quiero mucho, mi cara malito. You all in English, you just say, I love you.
Mm.
So I might say, man, big boy, you know I love the fuck out you, bro.
Right.
You know I'm saying it like that because I'm putting the emphasis, the passion in it. And my daughter, she's so brilliant. She ain't number 3.
Mm.
Kaza, don't fuck with us while we praying. Don't come over here fucking with us while we praying. Right. We was just on the plane and my daughter dropped something. She said, shit. The little boy in front of the little white kid, he was like 5. She was like, shit. The little dude say, Mom, she said a bad word. My little daughter look. Telling her. I'm supposed to be with that telling her.
Right? She said that.
Yeah, you're supposed to be with that telling.
Big boy neighborhood. All righty, man. We about to come up on Father's Day, man. Do you celebrate? Are you looking for anything? Are you happy,
Big
father?
Brother. And like a lot of people be like, Kevin, you can't say you spiritual because you dress Islamic. I am spiritual because Islam is about the intention of the heart. I got to put that out there. Mm-hmm. Nothing else took the needle out of my arm, took the syrup out of my cup, nothing else. You know, and I still drink a little syrup occasionally.
Go ahead now. You take all the syrup out your cup. Huh? Yeah, nothing took all it's the syrup out your
know,
cup.
You know, I dab. Yeah, you know. Heard me? Sometimes I dab, you know. Nah,
no,
my
no,
dab.
No, no, I got you.
Like this.
Right. Yeah, dab. You know, I might just, yeah. I ain't about to do all of, you right. know, shout out Young Miser. But, nah, no, Big Brother, I don't celebrate that. Like, my wife make me feel like it's Father's Day every day.
Every day.
I'm daddy.
Yes, sir.
She make me feel like that every day. Like, she stay coming, fuck with me some kind of way. And I mean, when I say the word F-U-C-K, fornication under carnal knowledge, it's in the Holy Bible. Like, when they say fornicate under carnal knowledge, the fuck word, it's abbreviated. I don't see why it's such a bad word. But anyway, when my wife come fuck with me, that make me feel good. I like that when she just come pick something on my face. Or, you know, just do something to make me feel like you notice
me. Yeah, man. You Let me know, pop I'm, that pimple right there.
I might grab ahead, on man. Her ass or something. You know what I'm saying? You know, I do that all day.
As girl. You should, brother.
Yeah, I grab on her ass or something, slap on her little booty or something. You know, when we be walking, that be to let her know, babe, I'm back here. You know, I'm with you.
Hey, man, my wife going to be listening like, hey.
You are not alone. You are not alone. You know right what I'm here. Saying? So every day is Father's Day for me. I challenge anybody, go look what Christmas, just the real meaning of it. Go look up what it meant. You know, because me, I'm a big skeptic. Like, I want to know what it mean. Like, what this mean? They murdered babies. And they used the skin, the fat, and put them on the candles. And hung them on a tree. Like, I'm not about to do that to my child. You hear me? Like, no, Doug, I'm not about to do all that. I'm sorry. I may have said too much. You can bleep that out. But I whenever I celebrate something, I want to see what it mean.
Right.
And then my birthday, I never celebrated my birthday because all my friends was murdered on their birthday.
Nah, brother.
Wow. Damn.
Celebration, you know, boom, 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 you know, rest in peace. So I never went out on my birthday. It all be the day after. And it just that I just don't celebrate birthdays. Now, I did get my son a cake. I got my son a cake, but it was like days after his birthday. And I don't know why I'm like that.
Just happened to get it.
I used to think I was cursed. Like, everybody I know just died. But I wasn't the one that was in the wrong. I just had the wrong type of friends.
Let me ask you this, man. If there were two envelopes or envelope in front of you, and in that envelope was the exact day that you were going to pass, would you open up that envelope and look at that date? Or Big would brother, you leave it sealed?
I know this is going to sound crazy. Big brother, I can't die. I can't die. Like, I can't die. So that don't even make sense to me. This is going to sound crazy. People not going to understand it, but those that get it, get it. I'm one of them. I can't die. I've tried twice. I can't go. I can't go. Until you fulfill your purpose, you will not leave here, Kevin.
I heard that. Kevin, brother, let me tell you, it is a pleasure
and then
to sit with you.
It's a pleasure. And we could turn the mic off for this one. I'm going to translate over. This is the last time that I do life. I will translate over into a greater energy that will not be able to be seen by the naked eye. You can't see protons, atoms, neutrons, electrons, but they are the most important molecules on Earth. So I'm going to translate over into something greater. I would never see death. It was others before me that did it. I'm one of those.
Appreciate you, brother.
I appreciate you, bro.
Thank you for coming and hanging with us,
man. Thank you for having me.
Easy call. Kevin Gates in the neighborhood, man. Big boy in the neighborhood.